and welcome back. I thought that I would share with you some of my tips for being in the best place that you can be for a performance. I know some of you have asked me questions about that. So I think the most important thing is feeling prepared, and that not only comes from, you know, knowing what you're going to sing or speak, or, you know, what you have to perform, and knowing that as well as you possibly can, but it's about feeling in really good health. Because your, you know, your body is your instrument, you've got to really look after it. So I take things like effervescent vitamin C and multivitamins, and I try and take those quite regularly. So things like this, you can get any kind of brand, but as long as they're like usually 1,000 milligrams, put them in water. If you're feeling ill, like you're coming down with something, try and do this maybe 3 times a day. And the other thing which is really good, and this is very natural, is echinacea. I normally do like a little glass of water, 14, 15 drops in a little tumbler, 3 times a day, if I know that I'm coming to a big performance and I want to make sure that I'm not going to pick up any bugs. That is really, really a good thing to do, but don't do it every day because your immune system gets used to it. So only save that for the big things. If you do get sick and you feel like you're losing your voice, Manuka honey is the one thing I would highly recommend that you get into. You can get Manuka honey. Manuka honey is, so it's when the bees feed on the tea tree plant, and they therefore have natural antibacterial qualities. You can get Manuka honey in most places now, and any kind of brand. But the best thing to look for is where it says like plus and a number. This is plus 10, but it goes up to plus 25, plus 30. And the higher the number, the more active it is, and therefore the more it's gonna work. So I always try and get like a plus 30, and take a teaspoon of it, hold it in your mouth, and let it dissolve down your throat. Never put it in hot water, because once you put it in hot water, you kill all the good stuff off. So if you're gonna come down with a sore throat and you need to quickly remedy it, that's the best thing. You can also put it on burns and stuff, and it is a miracle thing. So those are the things to keep you in good medical health, tip-top shape. But when it comes to nerves are such a bad thing for a singer. And the best thing to do is to almost think of it in a mental way. Nobody in the audience wants you to do badly. Everybody there is willing you on. So you've got to try and think, well, this is a great opportunity. I enjoy this. I want to enjoy this moment and make it the best that I can. So try and relax. Try and relax the throat, because the minute you get nervous, your throat does this and you're not going to sing very well. And just enjoy it for what it is. And if worst case scenario that doesn't work, just imagine everybody naked. I think I get most nervous when I'm singing with somebody that I really admire. So when I sang last year in Abu Dhabi with Jose Carreras, you know, he's such a legend. I used to go to the library at the Royal Academy of Music and sort of go and study his recordings. And then here I am doing my debut in a new place and singing duets with Jose. In that scenario, that is really quite overwhelming. And I get nervous because I want to be my absolute best. So I certainly think if I'm singing with somebody like that, it puts extra pressure. As a rule, I'm a pretty calm performer. I do get now and again a little bit starstruck. Probably the most major time was Kylie Minogue backstage at X Factor when we were both singing at the final with the contestants. And just a bit of background information is that, you know, when I was like one of the first albums I bought was Kylie. And so now if I ever play that before I go on stage, it sort of takes me back to a time, gets me in the mood. So then when you have Kylie Minogue like knocking on your Winnebago door saying, hi, I just wanted to come and say hi, I was a little bit like, take me back to 7-year-old Katherine and Neith. Like, I never would have believed that. So yeah, I was pretty starstruck then. My first big performance was not that long after signing the record deal. I was 23 and I got asked to sing the national anthem at the Millennium Stadium in Cardiff for an England-Wales match. Now, being a Welsh girl, to sing the anthem is like the absolute pinnacle, and I was so excited. I'd always wanted to do it, but it meant that in the week in the run-up to the performance, I couldn't sleep. I was having like sweaty anxiety nightmares, thinking about the 74,000 people who were just in the stadium and then all the millions of people that were at home. And I remember being in the tunnel, walking out, you know, waiting to go on and thinking, this is just like horrific, I'm so nervous. And then all the crowd started singing Delilah by Tom Jones. And it really reminded me of being in the crowd and thinking, I'd love to sing the anthem one day. And I thought, here you are, you're actually doing it. Enjoy this, don't let this moment pass. And you ruin it because you're just, you know, you're putting too much pressure on it. Just go out there and enjoy it. And that's what I did. And it absolutely was one of the best things ever. I was on a complete high for ages afterwards. So I think that really like applies to any nerve-wracking situation. You know, life is short, enjoy the moments. Don't let the nerves spoil it. Just take a minute and breathe and smile and just make the best of it.